And our logical reasoning allows us to look at new problems in terms of familiar problems. It also allows us to transfer knowledge from familiar problems to new problems. A high-level process for analogical reasoning is shown here. It consists of five major phases: retrieval, mapping, transfer, evaluation, and storage. We'll discuss all five stages in detail. Let us compare for a moment the process for analogical reasoning in general with the process for case-based reasoning within domain analogical reasoning that we discussed earlier. Notice that retrieval, evaluation, and storage are common between the two processes. In case-based reasoning, the target problem and the source case were from the same domain. They had the same kind of relationships and the same kind of objects. We simply had to adapt the source case to address the target problem. In analogical reasoning in general, the target problem and the source case need not be from the same domain. When they are not from the same domain, we can't just take the source case and adapt it. We first have to map the target problem and the source case. That is, we need to address the correspondence problem. What in the target problem corresponds to what in the source case? As an example, the laser beam in the target Dunker radiation problem corresponds to the rebel army in the source case. Once we have mapped the concepts and relationships in the target problem to the concepts and relationships in the source case, then we can try to transfer some of the relationships in the source case to the target problem. We can first abstract those relationships and then transfer them to the target problem. As an example, in the Dunker radiation problem, we first did the alignment. That is, we addressed the correspondence problem. What in the target problem corresponds to what in the source case? Then we took the relationship and abstracted it. The relationship in that case was, take the resource and decompose it into several smaller resources and send them to the goal at the same location. That particular relationship, that particular pattern is what we abstracted and transferred to the target problem. Note that this is just one theory of analogical reasoning. In other theories, some of these boxes are configured differently. For example, in another theory, mapping is a part of retrieval. You do mapping in order to do retrieval.